Hello, this is Lindy with another version of Life After Divorce, the place we come together to encourage and help other people in our same situation and other people who are in totally different situations but could still use a little encouragement. Why not? Life is tough. It's easier knowing that we're going through it together. So today's topic is kindness. And I truly believe that every person has goodness inside of them. Some people are really good at letting that kindness, that goodness, that thoughtfulness out. And other people, that kindness is in them, but they don't necessarily show it as well. And so we just want to talk about how we all have the ability to be kind. Kindness starts in your mind. I really believe this. I think that it starts with a nice thought, and for some people, it ends there. They think, oh, wow, what a pretty dress she's wearing, or what a great watch he has, or what a thoughtful act that was. That person is so nice. And they let it go. And we need that thought to go from here to here. That's all, from here to here. It's a short 9-inch trip. So we need to start acting on the kind thoughts we have. And if you're saying, well, I really don't ever think like that, it never occurs to me, practice. Okay? One simple way to show kindness is through a sincere compliment. Stop and look and say, what do I like about my sister, my brother, my best friend? And when you stop and think about it and say, you know what? They are really great at fill in the blank, whatever their hobby is, baking, cooking, eating. You know what? I truly do appreciate a good eater, because if I'm going to go to the trouble of cooking, I want you to enjoy every morsel. And I've had friends who are great eaters, and they make me feel great as a cook because they're good at eating. And it sounds like a silly compliment, but I'll tell you what, if you ever made a great meal and had to save half of it or throw it away because nobody ate it, you don't feel good about yourself. And you start questioning your own cooking. So being a good eater, compliment them. Okay? The kindness can be in something small, maybe a small gift. Maybe you want to go to the dollar store and buy them a coffee mug. Maybe you want to get them a candy bar. Something. It doesn't have to be a big thing. But think about how a compliment or a dollar gift can make somebody feel really, really great about themselves. Other ways, let me see. I had some things written down so that I could give you some great ideas. This is a really good one, and this, again, costs you nothing. Listening. Be a good listener. Make it a point. Make it a priority. Make it your goal to be the best listener you could possibly be. That means no interrupting. That means nodding and agreeing and showing you understand. It means asking intelligent questions to show that you were not texting or perusing your phone or your mind was on something else. So be a really active listener. And you know, these small acts of kindness might not only make another person feel great, they will make you feel good. You are going to feel wonderful by being a kind person. And yes, this is a win-win-win. You might encourage others to be kinder and more thoughtful and more generous with their compliments. You might motivate somebody else to just be nicer and just think of the great domino effect. By being kind today, you motivate somebody else who's then kind to someone else, on and on again, and we have a better world. All because you were nice. What a great concept. Yeah, so today's word is kindness. I am Lindy, and this is Life After Divorce.